President Cleveland had two interesting things. One, he married also a woman much younger than he, and they had their honeymoon at a resort in Maryland, a wall because of the intense public interest in this presidential May-December romance. A press corps hired a private train, followed the presidential couple to the resort, rented a house within sight of theirs, and staked out, the president said, ruined their entire honeymoon. A much more serious and potentially tragic episode occurred later in the Cleveland administration, actually toward the beginning of his first of two separated terms. The president developed a sore in his throat. It was diagnosed as throat cancer. There was a financial disturbance at the time. The president did not want his health to become an issue in what could become a financial panic. And so in an elaborate situation put together by a team of doctors and a dentist and the president's friend who owned a luxury yacht, the president went out to sea in that yacht, the Oneida, and given anesthesia, lashed to a mast in an interior cabin, and the dentist removed teeth, the doctors went in and removed the cancer, and the boat continued its voyage until they reached the president's summer house on Cape Cod, whereupon the president went in and recuperated. No one was ever told. The press didn't find out about it, but they almost did. They almost unraveled this very complicated story. But it's held together, more or less, and held for 17 years until the lead surgeon, becoming elderly, decided that the president was long since gone and he should tell the story to the world. It was probably the most successful medical cover-up in presidential history that we know about. And the use of a vacation was central to its success.